Hello everyone! In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this oil painting cartoon effect in Photoshop. After following this tutorial, you will create your own cartoon effect PSD file. And with that file, you will be able to reapply the same effect on any new image with a single click. Please like the video and let's get started. Step 1. Create the cartoon effect. Let's start by creating a new document. Set both width and height to 2000 pixels with 300 resolution and RGB color mode. Then click Create. Now go to File, Place Embedded to import your image. Just select your image and click Place. Resize your image to make your object's head fill the canvas like that. Then press Enter. If you press Ctrl and T, you'll find that your image is bigger than the document itself. And I want to crop these extra areas to avoid any problems in step 3. Just press Ctrl and A to make a selection, and with your layer selected, press Ctrl and J to duplicate what you've selected. This will make a duplicated layer with the same document dimension like that. Now let's delete the old layer and the background layer. Right-click your layer and convert it to a smart object. Now select your layer, and let's apply the Liquify filter from here. To get this new Liquify filter, you will need any Photoshop version above CC 2015.5. Now let's go to the Face Aware Liquify section to easily control the facial feature settings of each face. In my case, Photoshop will automatically detect two faces in my image. And if your image has one face, you'll get a single face setting right here. Now click on this little icon to link every two sliders together. Then start increasing the eye size to 100, height to 70, and width to 50. Also increase the nose height and width to 100. And for the mouth, increase both upper and lower lips to 100 and minus 100. And finally, for the face shape, you can change it to minus 50, minus 20, minus 100, and 15. Or just use any other values you want. Repeat the same settings for the second face if there are two faces in your image. And now let's see the before and after. Click OK and let's continue. Now let's go to Filter, Stylize, and choose the Oil Paint filter. If your oil paint filter is missing or grayed out, please check this video description. As you can see, this filter will add an oil paint effect to your image like that. Just change its values to 5, 3, 0.1, 0, and uncheck lighting. Then click OK. Now let's open the filter gallery. And inside the Artistic folder, pick the Poster Edges filter. Change it to 10, 0, and 6. This will add black outlines to your image edges like that. Click OK to submit. And again with your layer selected, go to Filter, Blur, and choose the Surface Blur filter. Change its radius to 20 and threshold to 10. As you can see, this filter will make the skin smoother and remove any unnecessary details like that. Now let's reapply the oil paint filter again. Leave the values as before and click OK. Finally, let's go to Filter, Sharpen, and choose the Unsharp Mask filter. Change its values to 150, 8, and 8. As you can see, this will increase the sharpness of the final effect and boost the details like that. You can also add an extra Smart Sharpen filter from here to increase the details and remove any remaining noise. Just change amount to 150, radius to 1.5, and reduce noise to 100. Then click OK. And here is the final result. Before moving to the next step, let's hear from our today's sponsor. Social Book Photo Cartoonizer is a free online tool to convert your images into a cartoon effect with a click. Just upload your image from here, choose the style you want from this menu, click on Cartoonize, write the capture, and wait a few seconds. And here is the result. You can choose a combo style to test three different styles together like that. Let's have another example. I will pick this caricature 1 style and click on Cartoon Eyes. And here is the final result. I really like this aging effect with its three different styles. And also this video preview for all combo styles like this one. And much more effects that you can test for free. Finally, you can get the high quality images without any watermark by joining their premium membership. Thank you, Social Book, for sponsoring this video. Now let's get back to our tutorial. Step 2. Add tone and adjustment layers. In this step, we will try to give some depth to the final effect using some adjustment layers and a simple trick. First, let's select our layer and press Ctrl and J to duplicate it. And with a duplicated layer selected, go to Filter, Blur, and choose the Gaussian Blur filter. Change its radius to 20 pixels and click OK. Now go and create an invert layer from here. Click on this little icon to clip mask it to the layer below. Also, create a black and white layer to desaturate it. Clip mask it too from here. Now select the top layer, hold the Shift key, select the third layer to select all three layers. Press Ctrl and G to group them, and rename the group Tone Opacity. Change its blending mode to Overlay. And you'll only need to decrease the opacity of this group to get the perfect tone for your effect. I usually use a value below 40%. Now let's add some adjustment layers. Let's start with a selective color layer. For the white channel, decrease the black all the way to minus 100%. This will increase the white color in the highlight areas like that. Name it White Opacity. Now let's add a vibrance layer. Change vibrance to 15 and saturation to 7. And finally, let's make a levels layer. Adjust its values to control your image shadows, midtones, and highlights. Now let's see before and after adjustment layers. That's great! Please note that whenever you update your image, you should change these two layers' opacities. And also adjust the other two layers' values if needed. Now let's move on to the final step. Step 3. Update the effect completely with a single click. To update this image, you'll only need to double-click on this Smart Object's thumbnail to open it. Once you're inside the Smart Object, go and import your new image from here. Resize your object to make the head fill the canvas like that. Press Ctrl and S to update your effect. Get back to your main document, and here is the result. You should adjust Tone Opacity, Levels, and White Opacity depending on your image like that. And here is the before and after. Before moving to the next example, let's save this project as a PSD file for any future use. Let's have another example. Open the Smart Object and import your new image inside it. Resize your image to make your object's head fill the canvas like that. Press Ctrl and S to update the effect. Get back to your main document. And that's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.